The best way to learn chemistry is to do chemistry practice questions. So here are 10 questions for you to try out on gases. This question covers the kinetic molecular theory of gas. To answer this question, you need to know the 5 assumptions of kinetic molecular theory. Options A, B, C, and E are right. The 5th postulate of kinetic molecular theory of gas states that the average kinetic energy is directly proportional to its temperature. Therefore, option D is not correct. This question is testing on real and ideal gas. Real gases deviate from ideal gas because they do have finite volumes and they do attract one another. That means gases that are large and have strong intermolecular forces will show deviation from ideal behavior. Now, among these 5 molecules, H2S and CH4 are large. H2S has dipole-dipole interaction, which is strong, while CH4 has London dispersion, which is weak. Now, even though H2O has hydrogen bonding, which is even stronger than the dipole-dipole in H2S, its overall size is smaller when compared to H2S. Now, for option C, H2S is the best answer. This question involves law of combining volumes. Since all the reactants and products in the equation are gases at the same temperature and pressure, that means the volume of gases are proportional to the molar volumes. The ratio of nitrogen to hydrogen gas is 1 to 3. Since we're given the volume of hydrogen is 90 liters, we can work backwards and figure out that we're going to need 30 liters for nitrogen. Now, if this is hard for you to see the math, we can set it up using dimensional analysis to find the volume of nitrogen. So we start off with a given 90 liters of hydrogen, multiply, draw a line across, and then we place 3 liters of hydrogen at the bottom, and then we place the 1 liter of nitrogen at the top. Now the liter of hydrogen is going to cancel out, and that's going to give us 30 liters of nitrogen. This question involves collecting the gas over water and asking which law to be considered when taking into account the pressure exerted by water vapor in the collection bottle. Here are the formulas for each of the gas law. The only formula that involves mixture of different gases is Dalton's law, where the total pressure is the sum of all the partial pressures, which in our case is the partial pressure for water and the gas. Therefore, Dalton's law is the law that we need to consider. This is a Boyle's law question because the question gives us the initial volume and pressure, and then it asks us to find the new volume at a new pressure, assuming constant temperature. So the formula for Boyle's law is P1V1 equals P2V2. Since we've already tagged the information that's given, we're going to plug it into this equation. And to solve for V2, we're going to divide both sides with 0.1 atm, and that gives us V2 is 40 liters. This is a Charles' law question because it involves changes in volume and temperature. We're given 500 ml V1 at 28 Celsius T1. The temperature changed to negative 10 Celsius, which is T2, and then we're asked to find the new volume, which is V2. Since all temperature given are in Celsius, we're going to need to convert them to Kelvin by adding 273.15. Any of the formula in gas law that involves temperature needs to be converted into Kelvin. So this is something to remember. The formula for Charles' law is V1 over T1 equals V2 over T2, and we plug in all the values that we have. In order for us to solve for V2, we're going to have to multiply both sides with 263.15, giving us V2 is 437 ml. This is a combined gas law question. The question gives us 15 degrees Celsius and 1.5 bar. That's T1 and P1. And then it tells us that the bubble rises to the surface, and then now we have a new temperature, which is 25 degrees Celsius, T2, and 1 bar, P2. And then it asks us what will happen to the volume of the bubble, which we don't have any information. We'll just leave it as V1 and V2. Since the question gives us temperature in Celsius, we're going to need to first convert it to Kelvin by adding 273.15. Based on what we have, we know that pressure, volume, and temperature changes. That means this involves combined gas law, which is P1V1 over T1 equals P2V2 over T2. So we plug in all the information that we have, and in order for us to answer what happens to the volume of the bubble, we're going to solve for V2 and we're going to do a little bit of algebra, and that gives us V2 is 1.6V1. So what that means is the new volume increases by a factor of 1.6 compared to the previous volume. This next question is on ideal gas law. We're given the pressure, which is 1 atm, and then we're also told the concentration of 1 mole per liter. So concentration is mole over volume. And we're also given the gas constant, which is 0.082. Since this question involves ideal gas, we're going to pull out the formula, which is PV is equals to nRT. We'll do a little bit of rearrangement so that we can get the V to the other side, and we just divide both sides with V, and that gives us P is equals to N over V RT. Notice that we already have N over V, which is 1 mole per liter, and then we have pressure is 1 atm, right? So we plug in all this information, and then we can actually solve for T. Now, in order for us to solve for T, we're going to do a little bit of math, divide both sides with 0.082, and that way we can solve for T, which works out to be 12 Kelvin. This next question is on gas density and ideal gas law. So we're given a density of 1.6 grams per liter, and then we're told that it has a pressure of 1 atm and 300 Kelvin. So this time the temperature is given in Kelvin, no conversion needed. And then we need to figure out the molar mass of the gas. We're going to use ideal gas law to help us solve this problem because we only have one set of data. So PV is equals to nRT. We know that moles can be obtained by taking the mass divided by the molar mass. So we're going to substitute that into our equation. Now we do a little bit of algebra so that we can solve for capital M, which is the molar mass. And that gives us M over V times RT over P. So we plug in the information that we have, which is 1.6 for M over V. And then R is 0.082. That's the gas constant. Temperature is 300 and then pressure is 1 atm. That means option D is the correct answer. This next question is on molar volume and gas stoichiometry. We're told that the combustion of butane happened at STP, which means 1 mole of any gas is going to have a volume of 22.4 liter. And then we're also told that the volume of carbon dioxide is 44.8 liter. And we can find the mole of CO2 by using the molar volume, which is 1 mole, 22.4 liter. And that works out to be 2 mole of CO2. Now that we have the mole of CO2, we can actually answer the question, which is what's the mole of butane? And to do that, we need an equation. And that's where the gas stoichiometry comes into play. So we have the entire equation. It might take you a little bit of time to write it out and balance it. If you need a refresher, here's a video on how to balance chemical equation. In order for us to find the mole of butane, which is C4H10, we start with the 2 mole of CO2 that we have already calculated. And then we're going to do just a simple dimensional analysis using the ratio that we have from the balance equation. So we just multiply and place mole of CO2 at the bottom so that they will cancel out, and then place mole of C4H10 on the top because that's what we want to find. And then all we have to do now is just to pull out those numbers from the balance equation. Those are the molar ratios, and that gives us 0.5 mole as the final answer. So how many questions did you get right? Check out this playlist for review or try out another chemistry practice questions. See you over there.